Okay, let us try solving Bode plot problems using MATLAB. So let us consider the first problem as g of s into h of s is equal to 80k divided by s into s plus 2 into s plus 20. Find gain margin, phase margin, stability, omega GC, which is gain crossover frequency, and omega PCA, which is phase crossover frequency. In the previous session, I have talked about how to determine the stability of a given open loop system if the Bode plot is given, right? So in this particular class, let us try to plot the Bode diagram in MATLAB. And from the Bode diagram, we can comment on the system stability. All right, so let us open MATLAB. Now, in the MATLAB, what you have to do is you have to construct the transfer function. As you can see, the numerator is consisting of 80k term, right, which is independent of s. So you need to construct the Bode diagram by considering k is equal to 1. So your numerator coefficient will be 80 into 1, which is only 80. So that's the reason in the numerator polynomial, you can take the coefficient as 80, which is independent of s, divided by, let us construct the denominator polynomial. Denominator is equal to, okay, let us key in the coefficients. So it is s into s plus 2 into s plus 20. So when you open up the brackets in the denominator, you will get the equation as s to the power 3 plus 22s square plus 40s. So coefficients of the denominator polynomial is s to the power, 1, 22, and 40. All right. And there is no constant term, hence you have to substitute the corresponding coefficient as 0. So let us substitute the coefficient starting from highest power of s, which is 1 space 22 space 40, and the EAN coefficient, which is 0. Put a semicolon. So semicolon will help you in saving the space. It will not execute first line as well as second line. Directly you can execute the Bode command. So you have numerator, you have denominator. Now you can construct the transfer function. Let us call our open loop system as SYS. Sys is equal to transfer function of numerator comma denominator. So transfer function of, that is the keyword here. You are not supposed to change. However, SYS can be renamed with some other meaningful term. You can even write OLTF. Press and enter. Once you have the system in hand, you can obtain the Bode plot. So command goes like this: Bode of the system. Okay. And I have already typed a second command, that is margin of transfer function of numerator and denominator. So this margin command, that is line 5 command, will give us the gain margin as well as phase margin printed in your Bode diagram itself. All right, let us save this file and let us execute. So this is the Bode diagram. The first diagram is your magnitude plot, which is decibel versus frequency. You can see here x-axis is frequency. The second diagram is phase angle variation with respect to frequency. So first diagram is your magnitude plot, second diagram is your phase plot. Now from the magnitude plot and the phase plot, you are supposed to identify the gain crossover frequency, phase crossover frequency, gain margin and phase margin. As you can see clearly, due to the command called margin of transfer function, the gain margin value, phase margin value, along with the phase crossover frequency and gain crossover frequency gets printed in your Bode diagram itself. Okay. So in your control systems lab, what you have to do is the MATLAB answers, you are supposed to correlate with the theoretical calculation. So I will show you what we got in our theoretical calculation. So this is the theoretical graph. So from the theoretical graph, you can observe somewhere over here, the gain crossover frequency we have obtained as 2 radian per second. On the other hand, if you look at the MATLAB, the gain crossover frequency is found at approximately 1.6 radian per second. So pretty close, which is quite acceptable. And if you look at the phase crossover frequency, that is the theoretical phase crossover frequency, is 6.6 radian per second. The MATLAB phase crossover frequency is 6.32 radian per second. So very, very close. So you can say that the theoretical graph is matching well with the simulation result. Similarly, gain margin from the MATLAB you have obtained as close to 21 dB, and theoretical gain margin is 20 dB, difference of just 1 dB. And the phase margin in MATLAB, it is about 47 degrees, and we obtained it as 39 degrees. So which is, you can say that the results are agreeing. So this is what you are supposed to do in your exam. Theoretical results, you should be able to correlate with the simulation results. And in the previous class, I had spoken about 3 cases, right? So whenever you are gain crossover frequency, so this is gain crossover frequency, the frequency at which the magnitude plot cuts 0 decibel line, that is gain crossover frequency. If your gain crossover frequency is less than phase crossover frequency, gain margin will be positive and phase margin will be positive and the system is absolutely stable. So this particular system is an absolutely stable system. Gain margin and phase margin are positive. There are problems in which you may get negative gain margin and negative phase margin. In such problems, your gain crossover frequency will be greater than the phase crossover frequency. You can refer the diagram which I have circulated in the class group. Okay, so such systems are called as unstable systems. Few systems in which the gain crossover frequency will be equal to phase crossover frequency, due to which gain margin is 0 decibel and phase margin will be 0 degrees. Such systems are called as critically stable systems. Refer to case 3 of the image which I had shared in the class group. Alright, fine. So you can determine the gain margin from the plot. So how will you determine gain margin? To determine gain margin, you have to identify or locate the phase crossover frequency, the frequency at which your phase plot cuts 180 degree line. So taking that as your reference point, draw a line vertically upwards. So this line will cut the magnitude plot at 2 points, right? One point is located on the magnitude curve and the other point is located on the reference curve. So this particular length refers to gain margin, and that length is equal to 20.8 decibels. Okay, so obviously you have to multiply this length with the scale, so that will give you 20.8 dB. Similarly, to find phase angle, what you have to do is you have to locate the gain crossover frequency. So here it is. And from the gain crossover frequency, draw a line vertically downwards such that that line cuts your phase plot at two distinct points. First point is located on the curve itself. The second point is located along the reference minus 180 degree line. And this particular length corresponds to the phase margin. So if your phase margin is found above the minus 180 degree line, you can take that particular phase margin as positive. Over here, the phase margin is found above minus 180 degree line. So what do you have in the region above minus 180 degree? You have the angles in the increasing order, right? If you compare minus 135 degree with minus 180 degree, you can say that minus 135 degree is greater than minus 180 degree simply because it is less negative. So that is called as positive phase margin. On the other hand, gain margin is, you know, analyzed in a different manner. So gain margin is found below 0 decibel line. So if the gain margin is found below 0 decibel line, example, this particular case, that gain margin is taken as positive. So if the gain margin is found above 0 dB line, then that corresponding gain margin is called as negative gain margin. Okay. Now, if at all the gain margin is, you know, crossing this 0 dB line, okay, anything that exceeds the limit is 0 dB, which is not a good sign. So crossing 0 dB line is not a good sign. Hence, we call it as unstable system. Over here, you can see the magnitude. Where is it lying? The magnitude is lying somewhere close to minus 20 dB, right? It is 20.8 dB. That means to say, to get 0 dB value, you have the provision to add further 20 dB. So if you add additional 20 dB, what happens? 20 dB minus the magnitude value at this point, which is also around 20 dB, it becomes 0 dB. So if you have any provision to add external gain, then it is called as positive gain margin. So in other words, if gain margin is found below 0 dB, it is positive gain margin. If it is found above 0 dB, it is negative gain margin. If angle is found above 180 degree line, it is positive phase margin. If the angle is found below minus 180 degree line, it is negative phase margin. So this concludes Bode diagram.